Good afternoon. My name is Adam Hodges from the Boeing Company, and it's an honor to be here today at MSPO 2021 here in beautiful Kielce, Poland. What I have behind me is the AH-64E model. We call it the Echo version. This is the version 6 aircraft that Poland is considering for its Kruk program. And so I represent the Boeing Company as a former Apache pilot myself. I flew 22 years in the U.S. Army. Retired just recently as a U.S. Army colonel, and it's my honor to talk to you today about this aircraft. So, as mentioned before, this is the first time the E model, the Echo, has been here at MSPO, and this unit, this aircraft is actually from the unit that is on rotation assigned in Poland based out of Powitz, the airfield in Powitz. And the unit comes from Fort Riley, Kansas, where they fly the E model aircraft. Prior to that, the aircraft that had come to MSPO were the D model Apaches, D as in Delta, which is also a fantastic airplane I flew for many years. But the E model is better, all right, and it's what we're offering for the Kruk solution. First off, it is a more powerful, more capable aircraft in all of its flight controls. It has an increased capability to fly in all forms of weather. It has full instrumentation for all instrument flight. But what makes it truly special are the increased capabilities when it comes to its mission systems. It has a better radar that can acquire targets at much further ranges. It has a new targeting capability in a maritime mode, so it can target sea targets, ship targets in maritime states. It has a dedicated air-to-air UAV sensor in the radar to better detect even the smallest UAVs. It has a much better capability with its manned-unmanned teaming. So the Apache is the only attack helicopter in the world that has four unique capabilities. The first one, which I mentioned, was the radar, but also it has dedicated manned-unmanned teaming. And you see on the top of this aircraft up here, it has a small diamond-shaped antenna on top, and that is the upper receiver of the manned-unmanned teaming system. And that allows the Apache to both share and receive the video feeds of fighter aircraft, of unmanned systems, of any sort of flying system in the airspace around the Apache, and the Apache can receive and share all of its video and target data. All right, and is the only attack helicopter in the world that can do that. Additionally, this aircraft has full Link 16 capability and integration. All right, and that has been resident within the E-model Apache since the very beginning. For the last 10 years, it's had full Link 16 integration. And then finally, this Apache has a modernized optical sight on the nose of the helicopter for better targeting. And is the only attack helicopter in the world that has not one, but two optical targeting systems. So the pilot can look one direction, while the gunner can look the other direction, two directions at one time. The aircraft has increased maintenance capabilities, where the aircraft will talk to the ground maintainers and tell them that there's a problem. So if the aircraft has a problem in flight, as soon as it lands, the maintainers are already there and they know what's wrong with the aircraft and they start fixing it. Makes it much more efficient and much cheaper to fly. A great point brought up is that Poland recently announced the intent to purchase the M1 Abrams tank, which is a fantastic decision. It's the best main battle tank in the world, in my opinion. And that is a system that was designed right alongside the U.S. Army's Apache. The U.S. Army introduced that system in the early 1980s and has continued to modernize both the Apache and the Abrams side by side. They work together in what we call the doctrine of combined arms, where the shock and firepower and the ability to hold land of the Abrams tank is coupled with the shock and firepower and reach and speed of the Apache. The U.S. Army never operates its Abrams tanks anywhere in the world without the Apache working right beside it. They were designed to work together to fight on the plains of Central Europe against a then Soviet threat, and they have evolved their systems in tandem together ever since to remain the greatest combat capability in the world, both on the ground and in the air. The Apache and Abrams go hand in hand. It's a decision Poland should make for their security of their future. In conclusion, you know, again, very happy to be here, very honored to talk about this tremendous airplane, and look forward to many years of partnership with the Polish Ministry of Defense.